Shalom, 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 yasharal. All right. Hope y'all are doing well. Excuse the coughing. I had to take my medicine. But yeah, so anyway, this is part two to the, Paleo Hebrew. Sorry that we only got through three letters yesterday, but it's kind of symbolic, because there's the 3 degrees of the temple, You got the Awalam, Hayakal, and Dabar, and, Awalam is kind of like your Alaf, your ox, because you're the ox, you got oxes over here with the sea of bronze. You got to sacrifice yourself as the ox. The ox is like the sin offering, the bull. You offer yourself up, you pass over the sea, of bronze, which is held up by the 12, which represents like our 12 forefathers, our 12 patriarchs. And then you enter Bayath, which is the house, and then, which is Ba, the second letter, Bayath. And then you, mess around in the house there, get all kinds of stuff done. And then, once you gain a certain level of understanding, then you have the Dabar, which is represented by Ga, or Gamal, which is the camel, as in you become joined, you become intertwined, you're measured. You're lengthened, as in length and width and height, and you bear the load of Yahweh. You've got hills and valleys, the humps of the camels. You bear water, which is the Torah. You're able to go through the deserts and survive, like in the wilderness. Just a bunch of stuff. So it all intertwines. And then when as we were going through the related words with Gamal, you see that in the negative aspect, if you're not doing, what Yahweh told us to do, you're in a bad sense. Basically, you're acting like Amalek. You're either acting like Amalek, and what we're about to see now is you're either a fucking Hamite or you're a damn Jew. Ooh, by the way, so I'm sorry, man. I Kwana's just got me fucking flying right now. Okay, so anyway, 1,000 miles in my mind, so fast, it's not even funny. But anyways, so Tahar, man, I have this fucking theory, man, from GMS, the head apostle, right, so-called apostle, elder of GMS, I have this theory, man, for some fucking reason, just the spirit, man, it's just been on me, just, it won't let me fucking, like, I'm like, nah, but it just keeps bugging me. And usually, when that happens, up, 9 times out of 10, I'm usually right about this shit. So, anyways, I think he's Jewish, man. Like, really take a step back and examine Tahar. I think the motherfucker's Jew, bro. I think he's a straight Jewish, bro. I think if anything, maybe he's like a quarter Israelite. I think this motherfucker's like a goddamn, like a straight motherfucking, like, dude. Especially because in one of the videos that, like, there was a video that popped up on my stream, on my little, whatever the fuck, the subscriber shit. And it was a video of Tahar testing the live stream. And it was just like, it's like you couldn't, because of the lighting. Like, I wouldn't even doubt if they put makeup on this motherfucker, man. Like, you know what I'm saying? You don't even know. But if you look at it, just look at his like side profile. Without no lighting and shit, the motherfucker's got like this Jew, bro, he's Jewish. Tahar's Jewish. And how fucking ironic is that, dude, that like GMS, this just this supposedly fucking macho ass fucking, but everybody knows how GMS is, dude. Wouldn't just how fucking sick would it be, dude, Tahar really was Jewish, man. Like that would, bro, that, But anyway, so and that's really what the mind state that they have is because they're not, they're not being Gamal or Gamar, what I'm saying? They're not being finished, perfected, completed. They're Gamar in the bad sense. They're in that darkness, the dark northern parts. They're being Gamar as in like a Gomer. They're being Japheth, They're being fucking Asian. They're being Amalek, because we have the word Amal, which is related to it, you know, Amal, which is where Amalak comes from, you know, so they're being Amalek, and then, like, we're about to see now, okay, so let's finish off the word. The next word we have is Kamar, which is where we left off at, and, you know, that links in with Kawam and Kam, which, you know, stands for Hamites, you know, and really, like, in specific Egyptians, but... So let's get this definition, because we got cut off last time on the definition of Kamar. So we're going to finish that definition first, you know, and then we're going to jump to Kawam, and we're going to get a few things in there, and then we're going to try to blast through the rest of this shit, and we're going to say Kawahala Yahweh Zaba'awatakad, which is all praises to Yahweh, the Master of Legions, who is one, you know. Oh, yeah. All right. So, fucking Zoom. Dude, I hate these phones are just the biggest pieces of fucking shits, dude, I swear. Alright, so anyway. Smart my ass. Alright, so, you know, we got Kamar, like I say. Okay, so check it out. Kamar's related word, you know, to Gamal. And it says to be hot, to burn, hence, right, transfer to color. Because it all, you know, it's compare with Kawam, you know. So these words, what's related, another related word is Kawam, which is to be hot or to burn, also in color, to have a glowing color, to be red of wine, like I was talking before. The Hamites are just so hot and burnt, they're like cooked, that they're not like, they're like a super dark fucking red, you know, because we all have like a red hue, but those motherfuckers is like purple. It says to boil or ferment, perhaps to foam of the sea, to bubble, swell, rise in heaps, right? Like, have you ever like burned yourself, you know, on like the stove or the oven, and your shit bubbles and swells, you know, you get like blisters and shit, you know? And that's how the Hamites are. They got blister skin, dude. The Hamites are literally warmer than normal people. Like, I don't know if you guys know this fact. Like, I don't know if you guys have ever, like, met Hamites and, like, interacted with Hamites before. Like, real Hamites, you know? But, like they're hotter, dude. Like, seriously, like, they're actually, their body temperature is literally, like, hot. Like, their skin, their flesh. They feel like they have a fever. You know what I mean? I don't know if you guys have ever. But anyways... It says to be an affirm, and the reason why is because my it's ridiculous. But anyways, to be an affirmant or to yearn, right? And there goes that, yeah, that yearning, the rumbling of the bowels under strong emotions. Example of that is Lamentations 1:20. Also to be red of the face in weeping, Job 16:16. Let's keep going down. It's related to Kamara says to cover with bitumen or with pitch. Right, so there's that bitumen, the pitch, the covering yourself, the covering over. It says to bear or carry, to toil. So there we go again. There's Kamal, right? Kamal, and then Kamal is what's related to Gamal, and then we have Kamar, right? Akin again to Amar. So there's got Amar and Amal. See, Kamar, Kamal, Amar, Amal, Gamal, Gamar. You know, they're all the same. They're because these are like the fucking gutturals. But anyways, it says, if you come down again, Kamar, it says ass, you know, so we got Kamar, we got ass, so it's like a, like the donkey, like the same thing, so it's an animal that bears loads, you know, so we got bitumen, pitch, slot, so-called probably from its boiling or bubbling up in pits near Babylon and in the Dead Sea, or perhaps from its being collected from the sources. Hence, the denomination Kamar, which is to pitch something fermented, hence wine. So it's like that pitch they get. They have like fields where that's where they get bitumen and pitch from. You know, it's just these like bubbling pit, like these tar pits. You know, like I don't know if you've seen like in movies and shit where they just have this like black tar boiling pit. You know, out in the desert. Let's see, wine, clay or loam. And it says, to be called from the idea of oozing or bubbling, like potter's earth, mortar, cement, mire, or mud. So these dudes, so like, that's it, because we're all created from the mud. We're all created from the dirt, the earth, you know, the clay. But these motherfuckers is burnt, you know? It's like, actually, let me get this last one, then I'm going to talk about it. A heap, also a dry measure, as in an omer. So that's where you get like an omer from, for so measurements. So like I said, again, it has to do with measurements. Okay, so now check this out. Because it talked about mortar and cement, mire and mud. Also, what do we do in Egypt? We gathered mortar and mud, and we had to get the straw and make clay. We had to make the mud bricks. You know, they had us fucking building adobe and shit like a motherfucker over there in Egypt. What happened when they started treating us worse? The worse they treat us, the more they'd make us do things. So they stopped collecting everything for us, and they made us go collect everything ourselves, plus be able to put out the quota for the day. You know, so you have more, which, you know, in the bad sense, this represents like the Egyptian mind state. You know, you're just like oozing, bubbling, being burnt up, being baked. Because you're being a part, and then seeing this links in with the whole thing about the Tower of Babylon. You're like becoming a part of the building of Babylon, like the actual building itself, like the House of Babylon, because we're the House of Yahweh, you know? Like we're like a part of this. We're the stones that make the outer part, you know, of the temple. We're all intertwined in the temple. But if you're not in the righteous temple, what? You're in the wicked temple, the temple of Baal, or the temple of Ezekiel, the 8th chapter. Right? The temple with all the abominations. Now, the temple with all the abominations, that's like the Tower of Babel. Now, the Tower of Babel, what did they do? They heated the bricks. You know what I'm saying? They were heating bricks. They were baking bricks to make the shit stronger so they could build the tower up higher. You know what I mean? And that's what's happening. That's what it is to be like the Hamite, because who were the ones that were doing the Tower of Babylon, or at least running the shit? It was the Hamites. It was the Hamites. Nimrod was a Cushite, and Cush was the son of Ham. You know what I mean? And then you have the fucking damn Canaanites who are mixing with the second influx of fallen angels, like after the flood too, dude. Like the Hamites did all that wicked shit, man. The Egyptians, like, come on, man. And like, so, you know, and I understand, because I seen Judah's video, you know, and I understand what he's saying about like the whole thing of like, you know, technically, like it, about how he was saying Freemasonry. Because James Smalls came out and said that Freemasonry was a child of Africa, and then Judah's like, no, well, they got all their shit from the white man and blah 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 and all that shit. And yeah, granted, they do nowadays have their like the Esau owns the shit and runs the shit, and really it's Amalek, because Amalek is Lucifer. So yes, I agree with that part, but technically, dude, it really is, and it's not a child of Africa, it's a child of Africans. It's not a child of Africa. It didn't come from Africa. Freemasonry actually technically came from Sumer. It came from Babylon, dude. It came from the land of Babylon. It came from Mesopotamia. So that's where Freemasonry was. But it was born of the Africans, because Cush had Nimrod, and Nimrod was the one who started all that shit up. They like you even said it yourself, and it's all in the amaze that, you know, obviously we're Judah knows, bro. We're both very heavily studied. You know what I mean? In their literature, like we know what they practice, we know what they do, we know their shit because we expose them all the time, right? And like, dude, it's Nimrod's the first. He's attributed to being the first Mason. You know what I mean? So like, it's that's where Freemasonry does come. It's not, but it's like I said, it's not a child of Africa, the continent. It's a child of Africans, the people who first inhabited that continent. That's their apportioned lot. It's called the South and the West, you know, like it's you guys gotta read the Book of Jubilees. But anyways, okay, now we're gonna go get Kawam, because this shit links in with that being hot, right? Because like I said, if you're not, you're a part of that mortar, the brick, you're then oppressed. If you're not, you're laboring for the Egyptians, you're laboring for Pharaoh instead of laboring for Yahweh. You know what I'm saying? Like that's what's happening. You're laboring, you're becoming Esau, you're Amalek, you're toiling for Satan. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, the serpent, especially, like you know, or like I said, like Kawam, it's either the serpent, you're laboring for Amalek and the serpent, or you're laboring for Ham. For the Egyptians. Okay, because look, if we got Kawam, let's get Kawam. I don't know why they separate Kawam and Kam. It's fucking stupid. It's literally the same word. Sorry, I keep coughing, man. I like got this shit stuck in the back of my throat. And it's just like bugging, it's itching, irritating. It's because I'm still coming off that thing, and I think the coughing kind of irritated my throat again. Okay, so Kawam. So what do we have? We have to burn or to be scorched, right? Akin to Kama or Kamam. Also Yakam, which is like the future. To be black. Okay, look, Arabic. It's the equivalent of Arabic. To be black, hence Kawam. Adjective, masculine, black or dark colored. Genesis 30 and 32, right? And then Kawama, it's the feminine of a wall or a town wall, right? And then it goes to Kawas. But look, Kawama, which is the feminine, right? It's a wall, because why? You're building up, you're becoming part of the black wall, bro. You're like, these motherfuckers is building this giant, like, black ass scorched wall, and like everybody's becoming a part of it. Like, that's what happens when you're not, like, you're initiated into the wrong shit, you know what I mean? As in, like, temple knowledge, as in wisdom, because, like, you got to go through the mental. See, this with things with ours. Ours is all mental initiation. They do, like, their faggot-ass kundalini bullshit, you know? And this is what happens. You become a part of their wall. You become kawama. You become burnt, also scorched. You become black, dark-colored, you know? You're a Hamite, dude. And then, okay, so let's go to Kam. Fast forward to Kam. Okay, here we go. Alright, starts right here. Kam, right? What is it? Masculine, a father-in-law. Right? So they say it can mean a father-in-law. And then what else does it say? You know, which is ironic, because, you know, father-in-law with Kam, right? And who was the one that was oppressing Jacob? You know, the father-in-law, Laban, which Laban means white. You know what I'm saying? So, like, it's either if you're not with Yahweh, you're a part of the damn Masonic black and white checkerboard shit, dude. You're either white with the Amalekites, or you're fucking black with the damn Hamites. And what does it say? It says warm or hot, adjective masculine, warm, hot, as bread just baked. You know what I'm saying? As garments also. It says swarthy of the son of Noah. See, look, proper noun masculine. Look, it's pronoun, noun masculine. It says, look, swarthy of the son of Noah, whose descendants are enumerated in Genesis 10, 6 through 20. Proper noun of the Egypt among the natives. So see, this is why you always have those stupid Chemites, you know, the Kemet, it's actually Kam. But, you know, Kemet, they're like always, it's Kemet. They're doing the same. They're fucking Egyptians. They really are Egyptians, dude. Like, they really are Egyptians. Like, I'm not even fucking around. Like, they really are Egyptians. Dude, what do you think happened to some of the Egyptians? Like, we didn't go into slavery alone, dude. Just we just didn't. It's just too apparent, bro. We didn't go into slavery alone, dude. And, you know, just, come on, man. Anyways, Egypt among the natives. IQ the Coptic. Right, Keme, or Blackland. So it even tells you polite even came out with a little bit. The Blackland. Yeah, it is the fucking Blackland, and that's why it's called fucking Blackland, because y'all motherfuckers is swarthy, yo. Y'all motherfuckers is black as hell. And it says to heat, masculine, heat, opposite to quar, which is cold. From this Semitic source, the same root being also found in Coptic, came through the Arabic, our alchemy, or chemist, right? Having reference to heat as the dissolvent or means of analyzing substances. Hence, chemistry is fitly said to be the science of heat. So see, that's what it, look, and even comma, look, to wrap together or to thicken or curdle. So something curdled, man, you're curdled, to be hot, to burn, right? Heat or anger of wrath, right? Soft curds, curdled milk. Milk, so you're rotten milk, yo. You're curdled milk. You're some fucking cottage cheese, man. You know what I'm saying? A bunch of cottage cheese ass niggas, dude. Look, so you have, and then alchemy, and that's what alchemy is, like a big old thing amongst the Masons. You know what I mean? Especially amongst the mystery schools and shit. Like, those motherfuckers is all about their alchemy, dude. And that's why, it's because it comes from the Kemet, man. It's A lot of this shit was African. It really was, dude. They really were a lot of the first ones to do a lot of bullshit. But that's the thing, is it was all bullshit. You know what I'm saying? Like, they're the all congratulations for being first to be just totally some wicked ass motherfuckers, bro. Yeah, you know, congratulations. You know, because that's, you know, I don't know exactly why you would be proud of some shit like that, but you know, whatever. And then we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna jump into the Jacinius, and we're gonna get the definition on Kwam and Kam again, but just to kind of see, you know, get another little additional aspect. Let's see. Kwam. Okay, here we go. Kwam. Kwam, an unused root. To be black, properly to be burned or scorched, compared to the cognate kamam, right? The Arabic, to be black, right? Again, look, black, a wall from the root kama, to surround, right? The wall of a town. So you're surrounded, man. That's this being locked in, surrounded in the box of Egypt. You're kwam, man. You're stuck in the awalam. You're just all fucking sealed in and uptight and bricked out and fucking all that shit, right? And then what do we got else? Okay, now let's just go to Kam, because that was it for that. See, it's kind of, you know, basically the same definition. Let's see. Just jump forward to Kam. Ah, man, my allergy's starting to kick in now. Shit. All right. Ugh. Fucking awful. Okay. Kam. In the thesaurus, referred to kama, unused root to join together, right? So it's joined together, a father-in-law, you know. Let's see. In relation of either husband or wife, father-in-law. Let's see. Contract affinity to become a son-in-law. Son-in-law, one espoused, evident. Okay, let's jump down. Okay, so the second definition, hot or warm, from the root kamam, used bread, as in newly baked bread. So that's what it is. And God Ham, the son of Noah. His descendants, so are described as occupying the southern regions of the earth. This is very suitable to the name of their progenitor, which signifies hot. And that's why, it's because they dwell in fucking Africa, which is hot as shit. You know, and then because it's hot as shit, these motherfuckers is like baked ass bread, fermented fucking milk, all curled up and blacked out and shit, you know, so they just got all super dark. Kam, a name of Egypt, properly its domestic name amongst the Egyptians themselves, so they did call themselves Kam, Kamai, right? Kemite, Kamai. But however so inflected that the Hebrews supposed Ham, the son of Noah, to have been the ancestor of the Egyptians amongst other nations. This, of course, was the simple fact if we are to believe that God has revealed. So, you know, and that's the only thing I don't like about the GC, is he kind of adds his little fucking two cents in here and there. So he's like, oh, you know, if we believe the word of God is true, then what the fuck are you even doing this lexicon for, you dick? Well, whatever. The name of Egypt is the more recent Coptic tongue written as Kemet. It says in the Sahidic dialect, right? Kemet, words which signify blackness and heat. As Plutarch observed, right, according to the Coptic etymology, signifies black, hot, or heat. Hieroglyphic language, as it is written, with the two letters Ka and Ma, right, Kam. Egypt is so named likewise in the Rosetta inscription, in which the word occurs more than 10 times, and is read by Champollion as Keme. Okay, so, you know, it's Egypt. It stands for Egypt. Heat. It's fucking hot. Curdled milk. Growing together. You know, anger, heat, anger, curdled milk, you know, cheese. There we go, look, just some cheesy ass motherfuckers, you know. Okay, and then Kamam. Yeah, see, look, and then remember we saw that to become warm, to warm, to be hot, you know, to made hot, burning, also for lust, we got make warm, make oneself warm, and, you know, and then that's it. So it's just being warm, man. It's just warm ass motherfuckers. Okay, so anyways, that was the end of Ga. Finally made it past the third letter. Okay, so now it's gonna go a lot faster. I mean, Da's like kind of decently alright, big too, but it'll go a lot faster. And then so like I said, just, you know, recap, that's like the 3 degrees that we just passed through in a sense, you know, the Alaf, you know, the Bayath, and then the Gamal. which if you are not properly gamal, you're either gonna go to the left or to the right, which is like Amalek or Hama or Egypt. So you're either gonna go with Amalek and Esau, or you're gonna go with Ham and the Egyptians. If you don't stay, centered, don't stray to the left or to the right, stay on the straight path, to which then you will be the perfect load bearer, a servant, I guess you could say. Okay, so the next one is Da. Numeral four, Dalath, the door, right? Triangle-shaped tent door, which is the letter D. Then we're gonna get that in some proof within the lexicon back in the Davies and Mitchell. Okay, so we're just gonna try to fly by this shit. Let's see, Da. Okay, Dalath, the fourth letter in the Hebrew alphabet, hence used also for the numeral four. Its form, an early Phoenician Hebrew inscriptions, is D, this, whence the Greek Da and the Roman D comes from. So it's D. Its name, Dalath, in the rabbinic, is the same as Dalath, which is the door. So that means a door. Its primitive triangular form was probably intended to represent a tent door. The form and name, whence the Greek delta, served to suggest by the initial sound and the force of the letter, which is either D or the softer D, equals RTH as in thou, but it's not thou, it's just the D, because we already have a thou, which is the TH, the D. So I don't get why they do shit like that. But anyway, now we're gonna go to Dalath. And it's related to a few words as well, but not nearly as many as good old Gamal was. All right. So we got Dalath, right? And we got what? Feminine, a door. It says the dual signifies folding doors or gates, right? The plural is leaves of a folding door or gate, the door, pages or columns of a roll or a scroll of a manuscript as well. That's very interesting. Which resembled the opening leaves of the folding door, which is, and the reason why it's because it's pages or columns of the roll or scroll of a manuscript, which is deep because like columns, so it's like the manuscripts, represent. It's like the manuscripts unfolded. If you were to un, because usually they the scrolls come together and then you unfold the scrolls, and it's like the pillars of the scrolls that you unscroll, right? And then you come up in these even like the little knobs that you have at the end of them. And when you read, it represents like the Torah. You read the Torah, you read the scrolls, and you're able to enter into the door of the house. You know what I'm saying? It's entering the doors. And there's always like like there's the curtain. There was the curtain, but now there's no curtain right here. And there is a door, obviously, but the scrolls. So you have to make it past the, you read the scrolls to make it into the door. And then you've got the veil with the Holy of Holies to make it into the other. So you got to make it through two doors, two humps of the camel. Anyways, it says, let's see, which resembled the opening leaves of a folding door. The radical meaning refers to the fact that doors hang and swing on their hinges, which goes in with, the Hebrew breakdown on the word cubit. You know what I mean? It's the same thing. It's like that hinge, which who are you hinged on? Are you hinged on the wicked woman? You know what I mean? Or are you hinged on Yahweh in the temple? So let's see. If you haven't seen the temple, it's under, I think that one was under the ark. I can't remember. Hold on. Let me see where I broke down that definition. Right. Okay, so it was on the Ark of the Covenant lesson. It's under the Amathiam, which means a mother, right? It's linked in with mother, cubit, or door, or base, right? A nation or idol terror. So that's that base, the base of the door, the hinge of the door. So, it's all about the cube. That's what cubits having to do with. It's all about which door are you entering into, Are you entering into the good temple or are you entering into the bad temple? Which, you want to enter the good temple. But, motherfuckers are stubborn. Okay, so anyways, now let's go to a related word, which is dalal. Okay, let's go dalal. All right, here. Okay, dalal. Right. So we have dalal, and it says to move to and fro, to be pendulous, to wave, henceforth to totter or to hang loose. And that's referring to like the door, you know, because the door would just be like flapping, you know what I mean? Just like if you don't, because it's like a pendulous, you know, swing back and forth, like, because, you know, the door's not solid. Like, think of a tent. Like, think of a tent door. If you ever had a tent door and you unzip it, but you zip it, you know, to where one of the sides is still on hinge, but the rest of it's not, it like flap, you know what I mean? Used to say to hang down, right, from men, to sway, to slack or weak, to languish, figuratively, like in shallow water, you know what it means, of the eyes to fail, the persons to be poor, to be brought low, you know what I'm saying? So like that's like that door, like the hanging loose, the being low. You know, and this goes in with the languishing. This is in like the negative sense, you know, you're hanging down, you're being blown with the wind, you're shallow waters, you know, you can't be that. You got to be the deep, right? And that's what the God was talking about, was being the deep. Now let's go to another related word with dalal. Is actually zalal. So we got to go to za real quick. I think it went too far. Okay, here we go. Zaka. Okay, zalal. Where's that? Okay, zalal. It says to move to and fro, hence to wave of a twig, hence to shake or scatter about or to squander, like a squanderer. You know what I'm saying? To be mean, bad, shaken, to quake, to despise. You know, shaking. And seeing this is why, because the door, you know, if you're not on the right hinge, you know, the door is just gonna, you know, and also has to do with like the sag. Like, I don't know if you've ever had a door that's like has a fucked up hinge and it like hangs a little bit, like sags a little bit, even like our solid doors, and it's all fucked up, you know. What did I want to add to that? What is it? Squander, you know, because if you don't also have your door, if it's not solid, and it's going to go into being wa. Really, this is the da, but with the door being like flappy, it's you're having to basically make your door solid, you know, which is nailing it down with like a pit. Like if you don't, you know, nail things down or hook things or fasten things properly, they're just going to hang and sag, you know. So it's going to link in with wa. But let's get another related word, which is salal. So zalal and sa, because you got the za and the sa, and sometimes they're interchangeable. Salal, because like I said, we're just getting like a proper understanding on these things, so we can fully understand. Salal, right? Akin to salah, properly to be high or pendulous, to raise or to heap up, especially to cast upon earth for making a road, a highway. Right, to raise or to elevate, to extol, to set oneself up a barrier, right, to wave or to wobble as the branches or the tops of the trees. And see, and that goes, that even, oh, look, and then we all got another, to prick or to pierce, to plate or to interlace, to mound a rampart, to throw up a rampart. So see, that's the thing, is it are you going to lay down? You know what I mean? Are you gonna be, you know, what did it say, cast down? Let's get a couple words. What was it? Useless things to hang loose. Are you gonna totter and wave and languish? You know, be of shallow waters of the eye, to, you know, failing eyes. You're gonna be slack or weak. You know, these are all curses of our people. Or are you gonna be the positive, which is like salal, which is to be high, to raise up, to heap up, to cast up earth for making a road, like to be a high, like to lift yourself up off the dust, you know what I mean? And like a road, like a, you know, road is usually like lifted up. Like think of like a sidewalk, you know what I mean? And then compared to like the streets that people drive on, you know, sidewalk is like elevated. You wanna be like elevated, a form of war. Like, and you don't want to wave or wabble like the branches or the tops of trees, which reminds us of the scripture for, you know, in Isaiah, the 7th chapter, when it says that when Ahaz was being told that the kingdoms of Samaria and the Arameans or the Syrians were joining together to come against Judah, says all the people were waving like trees, you know, they were like, what, like all fucking just being blown by the wind, you know, all savage, they're not being... they're not being plated or interlaced, you know, what they're doing is they're being pricked and pierced. You know? That goes in with the sinful, with the shatyam wood, you know, the pierce, the gold, the flogging, man. You guys, stripes are for the backs of fools, you know? Okay, we just have a couple more and then we can move on. Salah, because we saw Salah, right? Hold on. Fuck, I was like right there. Okay, Salah. Right, akin to Salah, to be pendulous or lifted up, especially of a balance. So it's being balanced, to be weighed in a balance, figuratively to be bartered or to valued. So it's getting your value, man. What are you, how are you valued? Are you valued low or are you valued high? Because think of a balance, you know? You have like the two weights, and that's the thing. Are you going to be the good weight, or are you going to be the bad weight? let's see. Fuck. Yeah, see, look, and then if you jump down, Salah, akin to Salah, and it has a, to be lift up, figuratively, to make light of, to slight, to suspended in a balance, to be weighed, to be bartered, you know, to be still, hence to be still or silent. Salah, to pause for silence, probably a musical term or sign, ordering the voice of instruments to be hushed. This word is found only in many of the Psalms and in Habakkuk, right? So that's where we get the word Salah, right? Like pause, like silence. That's what Salah means. It's like silence, like pausing. It's a musical term. it's just funny how people try to use it. They try to use it like if you're saying aman, which means like so be it, you know, like ending something. This is just pausing, you know, to take a pause or a silence to hear. And it's, you know, that goes in with the whole thing. When you enter the door, in order to learn to, because what did Gamal have to be doing with, which is what the Dabar, you know, it says, think of the third level, you had to be silent. You know what I mean? You got to learn. Sometimes you got to be still and silent and pause yourself for a second to receive information. You know what I'm saying? So sometimes this is why we don't always just pumping out video after video. Sometimes you have to pause and you have to be silent when you're in the temple. You know, there's times for everything, you know. It's balance. That's where we get balance from. And then also to pause or to be silent. Oh man, I fucking... Okay, so hold on. I gotta make me a side note right here of something because I fucked it up and I didn't. Okay. All right. So, anyways, moving on. Now we got so Salal is also linked in with Talal, and we're gonna go check out Talal real quick. Talal, right here. Kenta Zalal and Salah, see? To raise, to heap up, right? To heap up or terraced, like vine-clad mount, right? Elevated, to be hanging or dangling, to wave to and fro, right? But in the negative, it's to be cast, to thrown down, figuratively, to be fail or frustrated. So see, that's or plunt, you know, you also got to dupe, to deceive, to cheat, to be deceived, right? To plunder. So that's what happens. You either deceived and plundered and you're you know, cheated, you know, with the wicked temple. If you're being letting yourself being builded, you know, being a part of this of the wicked temple. But if you're being terraced and raised up and elevated and heaped up in the good temple, you know, then you don't have to worry about none of that. Okay, Talal, and then Tawal, actually, is a LinkedIn word. So we're going to go to the other T, and we're going to get Tawal. Okay, Tawat. Ha, Tawat. All right, so anyway, Tawal, right? To lift or to cast, to throw or to hurl, example, a spear. Right, and wasn't Nimrod a mighty hunter? To be cast as a lot, to be cast out, to be cast down or prostrated. Tawal sounds like Nafal, huh? Like the fallen ones, like the fallen angels hurled down from the heavens from their posts because they fucked up. Because that's what it really goes back. Nimrod and all them worship the fallen angels. So you're being thrown and hurled down. The Greek equivalent of this is katabolo. You know what I'm saying? And see, in the New Testament, cats don't even know about katabolo. They don't even know about the three earth ages that's taught about in the New Testament. They don't even know their goddamn New Testament. But anyways, to cast down, you know, also prostrated. You know, so it's that's how it is, man. Are you gonna be prostrated? Are you gonna be cast down, hurled down, cheated, duped, robbed, spoiled, plundered? You know what I'm saying? Or are you gonna stand up and be a mighty man, and bear the load and do the work and go through the door and take your moments of silence to hear the music? You know what I'm saying? Like, okay, so that was Dala. Now we're gonna go to Ha. And we've got Ha. Ha, name, Ha, or you could also, links in with Hawa, which is like a vent hole. Okay, so it's a lattice or a window. Okay, well, let's just go get it. Okay, so now we're gonna go to Ha. Abagada Ha. Okay. Oh, no, that's the wrong one. Okay, and then Wa is really short, so is Za. Like, a lot of them are really short, it's just some of them that have a lot to it. Ha, the 5th Hebrew letter, hence used also for the numeral 5. Its oldest form is discovered in the Phoenician Hebrew inscriptions as, you know, that, what I've been showing you guys. Or that, whence the early Greek Ha or Ha comes from the common or and the common E. So that's where they get the letter E from, so they just turned it around and they made it into their letter E. Its name, Ha, comes probably from Hawa, to breathe and to mean, and means a vent hole, i.e. Araba, a lattice or a window, which is formally rudely pictured. The initial sound and the shape suggested the power of the letter, which is H, as in hiss, except after a vowel where it is generally quises, unless it is marked with a Ha. So, and it's not after a vowel, what it means, what, supposed to be when it's at the end of a fucking word, really is what it means. When it's at the end of a word, sometimes it queases, like you say, like if you have a Ha, like you have Al and then you have Allah, you got Lah, Allah, you hit Allah, you know, you don't pronounce Alaha, you know what I mean? So that's how it queases. But besides that, it's just an H, it's an H sound as in hiss. You know, and obviously it's like a vent hole to breathe. It's like a window. And this is where we get Hawa from. And this goes in with the windows or the vent holes. Cause remember we've gone through, you know, Abaga, you know, you becoming, once you dwell within the holy place in the Bayath, right? Once you've entered the Dalath, the door, then you have the windows within the priest cells, you know. You have the terraced window. It's funny because that's even what Dalath was talking about, being terraced as well. So then when you enter the door, then you become terraced and you're like part of those windows, which is what the air comes through, you know, what through breath, the breath of life, the Hawa, that he is. Let's see. That's what are we getting? Ha as a prefix also means the. You know, all the pre, like, offer as a prefix means, I'll go through the prefixes and suffix later. I'll do it totally because that takes time. Okay, so it means low and behold. So like, ha, like low, ha. You know what I mean? And then you got, look, ha, ha-ah, or aha, you know, that's another, ho-ha, you know. Let's see, what else do we got? Behold, it's akin to han. So let's go get Han real quick. And Han means like Han Solo, you know. Han. Here we go. Up, oh, there goes a beam higher. Han, they. So it means they, so they're alone. They are one. Oh, they are one. Han Solo. But this original form occurs only, and that's actually what the Qumran community, if you read in like the forewords and like the writings of the Dead Sea Scrolls, you know, like Giza Vermes and whatnot, and like Weiss and Abeg and all them dudes, like they all talk about how the Dead Sea, they also call themselves the Yakad, Yakad, which is, he is one, you know, which is, that's funny, it's just Han Solo, you know. It says the form occurs in connection with prefixes there, therefore, this, that, lo, behold, you know, whether or themselves, you know. So we've got the way Hana. And then, okay, so Hawa. We saw that it was linked with Hawa. So let's go get Hawa real quick and see what Hawa is. And we should all know. We should just all know by now, because Yahawa, which he is the breath, you know, he is the existent one. In fact, let's get it. Hawa, right? It says properly to breathe, hence figuratively to live, to be, or to exist. He exists, he breathes, he lives. To breathe after something or to desire, right? Hence to desire. And it also means to expire or to die, hence to ruin, which it shows you. Hawa, Haya is also linked with that as well. Cause so it can mean ruin, because Yahawa is the ruiner. He's the consuming fire. He's the one that will fucking ruin just your whole, you know. What does it say in the Apocrypha, in Second Esdras, that who will not utterly be beaten to powder at his presence, you know? Like, utterly beaten to powder. Like, that's that type of ruin, man. That's that type of falling. Desire, cupidity, right? He thrusts this, so it's the, like, desire something. And it's funny because Yahawah, there is desire with Yahawah. Yahawah is a jealous God. You know, he desires righteousness from us. He desires a family of righteousness. The desire, and then also he desires to see the wicked punished. Ruin, calamities, destructive pestilence, mischievous, you know what I mean? So it's just, that's what Yahawah will cause, man. He will cause that pain if you're not with him. But if you're with him, it's life. It's breath. You know what I mean? It's life or death. That's it. It's life. That's what Yahawah is. Who Yahawah is. He's life or death, you know? Okay, and now we got Haya and Hawa, as in, like, with, but not with the ha at the end, with the ah, because they are interchangeable. So, like, you have Hawa, and then you have Haya. And it says he, she, it, right? So it's just he, she, it. That one, that man, those days, that himself, she, he, it, they, that, right? Because he is the one that breathes, you know, he's the existence. It also, let's go down. Yeah, so it just means like a person. So if you ever come across that, you know, Hawa, if you're like, he is someone, but you're not trying to use like Yahawah, you can it's substituted with the ah instead of the ha, you know. So just to show you, just to so you know the distinguishment. And then we get Haya, which is the equivalent to it, but with the ha at the end. Oh yeah, here we go. Haya. Let's see. See, it says it's akin to Hawa, properly to breathe, to live, but usually to be, right? Whether with the meaning to exist or to live, right? Or to be, example, when they were in the field. So it has to do with tenses. So Haya is dealing with tenses, you know. And it shall be, you know what I mean? It will come about, or it was, or you know what I mean? Haya always has like a context of like to come to pass, to occur. See, you know what I mean? It's like, it's tenses, to come into existence, to become something. It's to become, it's something happening. It's in the future tense, to be done, to be made, to desire accomplished, was, happened. You know, it also means ruin and calamity. You know, so it's the same thing, same word, just different, there's different tenses. Okay, so now we got wa. So let's keep it fucking moving, man. Let's keep it moving, keep it moving. So it just shows you that ha, that wind, the breath, the going through the door and being in the house with the windows, which have the breath of life, you know, Yahawah breathes that life into, you know, it comes from the sides, and you breathe, you gain the life, it pushes the blood, the oxygen, you know, that's what you want. You want that breath, the Hawa, to enter into your temple and give life to you, you know. And now we have Wa, right? And let's see what Wa is. Wow. Oh, I love seeing those two W's, man. Don't you guys love seeing that? No, O-U-V bullshit. says the sixth letter of the Hebrew, hence used for the numeral six. It's for, and that's why in the heat, you know, it, you got the monster, you know, the drink, the energy drink monster. It's three wahs put together. It's wah, 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 you know, 666. Its form in the oldest examples appears variously. Example, you know, you look like a four, that one, you got the classic Y, you know, so there's multiple forms. Representing a hook or a holdfast, which its name wow denotes, hence the old Greek bao, right? Known as the digama, the F, or Latin F, right? So it says, and the numeral G for six, right? And it says, see the table of ancient alphabets. I love this. Look, A. Its sound is W. Its sound is W. One more time, like the camps. Again, its sound is W. It's a O. Its sound is W. It's a U. Its sound is W. It's a V. The sound is W. Sorry, I had to, man. That's just fucking classic. That's just classic. But anyways, I do love that, man. Like, look at that. Look at, bam, in your face. Bam, blown up. Its sound is W. God damn it. A semi-consonant. What have I been telling you guys? Maybe I just tell my people over here. But that, like, that's where we get the sounds of the vowels. It's from the semi-consonants, which are the wa and the ya. They're semi-consonants, meaning that they can, what is a semi-consonant? Hence, easily passing over into a vowel, u or o, meaning the fucking sound can give the sound of the u or o, like shalom, and then you have shala wa wa wam, gives the wam sound, the u, the o sound, wa wa, you know what I mean? Like, that's, bro. Same thing with Y. You get the E. You get the E and the I sound. You know? Like Shamarai. You know, with the Ya at the end. Shamarai. Or you could be in the middle of the sentence. You could say, Ya. Yi. Yi. Yada. Ya. Yada. You know what I mean? Like, come on, man. Come on. Come on. Okay, look. It even shows you, look. This is awesome. It says, seldom used with its consonant force, as in hawa, shalau, shalawatai, and mostly becoming a ya, meaning they, when it's in the middle of a word, a lot of times they transfer it, switched over for a ya at the beginning of a root, as in yalad, or for walad. So that's what they'll do. See the Arabic walada. See, boom, W in the Arabic, walada. So you have walad and yalad. You know what I mean? Which means like a boy, like a young boy. So it's yalad or walad, but it's the same thing. So wa and the ya are interchangeable. And then we'll just get the definition for wa real quick. And as we see, it's masculine properly, a hold fast, hence a nail or a hook, perhaps akin to off, right? A vi to bind, right? Because you're binding, you're holding, you're steadfasting something. And that goes in with the like the tabernacle, the tent, because in the tent, if you go back to the original tent, the tabernacle, right, you had hooks. You would keep yourself, because what did Gamal have to do with? Gamal had to do with covering, which the covering in the Solomon's temple would represent the mitri. You know, you're putting on the mitri, you're binding the mitri, because you would bind the mitri with tzitzits. So you would bind this mitri, and then you would put the head plate on there, you know, and that's binding, that's gamal, you know, and then gamal, but on this sense, it would be binding the four outer layers of, or the four layers of the cloth of the coverings of the tent. You know what I'm saying? Which is the house. You're becoming stable. You're becoming solid to the ground. You're not flapping in the wind like the door, like in the negative sense, you know, with the door flaying in the wind. You're tying it up and you're tying it down. You're putting that hook to it so that the wind can flow freely. You're not just flapping in the wind. You know what I'm saying? And those four layers of the cloth, they're very symbolic as well. Two stand for the positive aspects and two stand for the negative aspects. You know, it has to do with the battle of Jacob and Esau, but that's another lesson and we'll get to that in another time. But now, so let's keep going. Let's get Zah real quick. It's Zion. seventh letter of the Hebrew, hence also for the numeral seven. Its name Zion, perhaps it also it's Zawan, because sometimes you won't find Zion. Perhaps meaning a weapon properly an ornament. So it's all, it's either a weapon or an ornament. And it, the ornament has to do, go, it also links in with whoredom, with being a whore, you're going to see. Zayana means like a whore. And its oldest form, Z, right? And Z, in some early examples, may perhaps rudely picture a sword or a spear, and its sound Z was suggested by the first sound in the name. Its form and name appears also in the Greek Z or Zeta, and our Z, see the table, so it's a Z. You know, obviously from the Paleo Hebrew, it's a fucking Z, dude. Okay, so Zion. Oh man, I lost my spot in my notes because I have all the words written down of where I'm going next. Okay, Zion. Yeah, Zion's short. Okay, where are we going? Yeah, we're going to Zion and then Zayana, and then that's it. For this letter anyway. Okay, Zion. There we go. Okay, well, let's get Zawan, too, because Zawan is, like, to nourish, right? Zawan, to nourish, to pamper, to be nourished or pampered, well-fed horses, right? Weighted, i.e. having heavy testicles. So that's that Zion, that's that, the same thing with, like, that. Like, that's the weapon, that's the having heavy testicles, being well-fed, well-fed horses. What did Yahweh say? He fed us to the full, and then when we fool, we fucking kicked. We waxed fat. You know, we went going into harlots' houses, which that's what the harlots' houses is. Like, watch, you're going to see, watch. Being pampered or nursed, because what? Once you pass what were we breaking down? The whole gamal, right? It's being weaned. You're weaned, bro. You're nourished, right? You're a well-fed horse, and you're weighted, right? What does it also mean? Zawan, to point or to sharpen, then to shape and form, as in like a weapon. And it also you become a sharp threshing instrument. You're a sharp threshing tool, man. You become shaped and formed. Yahweh shapes and molds you and fits you to a fit temple, man, you know? And then we've got Zawan, to deck and ornaments, hence to deck. So you're decking yourself as an ornament, which goes in with us, because not only are we his sharp, new sharp threshing instrument, but we are also the ornaments that he's going to decorate Jerusalem with. Because Jerusalem is like our mother, and he's going to deck her with all kinds of ornaments and jewels and all kinds of stuff, which is us, which is the people. We are the ornaments. But check it out, to be well fed, right? But look at the bad sense, Zawana, in the feminine, it's a harlot or a prostitute. Right? Referring to meretricious ornaments. So see, it's and then in the negative sense, it's like being decked out like a whore. Which is funny, because really being decked out like a whore is to cover yourself up completely. Okay, you know how they, the Muslims, and it's like kind of like a trend going around in Israel now too, where like these, you know, all the women are completely covering up from head to toe to where all you can see is their fucking faces. You know, and then the Muslims go so far as to cover their faces too, where all you can see is the eyes, and everyone's like, oh, how beautiful and how sexy. Well, actually, those are the clothes of a whore. Go look up fucking Tamar and Judah, dude. Go to the book of Genesis and look up the story with Tamar and Judah. Did she dress provocatively and take off clothes to be known as a whore? No, what did she do? She covered her fucking face. And that's how Judah thought she was a whore. Covering yourself up all completely like that, like Muslims, is a sign in Hebrew culture that you're a whore, bro. That, not even no fucking joke. You know why? Because that's ISIS, bro. That's ISIS. You're veiled. That's the veiled ISIS. ISIS is veiled. That's why Helena Blavatsky has a book called ISIS Unveiled. Because when you unveil the whore, that's what you know what I'm saying? I hope this is sinking in. I hope this is making sense, man, because like it frustrates me so much. Look, in the Chaldean, right, weapon properly something pointed, as in the lances, and others render it the harlots, right? So it means like a harlot, man, or a lance being pierced through, you know what I'm saying? Like it's like a bad weapon, like in the bad sense, like in a weapon, being turned against you. And then remember how we saw Zawan, how I talked about testicles, you know what I'm saying? Like having weighty testicles. And if I'm not mistaken, I think Zawan or Zion in the brown, I mean in the in the yeah, because if you go to Zana, right, because Zana and Zayana is linked in. Zana, look at it, it's to commit fornication, to commit fornication. So that's being the whore. That's committing the whoring because you were fat. That's why he tells us we were fat. We were Zana. We were Zayana. We were fat, and then we kicked, and we fucking went a whoring. Hold on, because if I'm not mistaken, Zawan also meant breasts, like hanging breasts. Hold on, I may be mistaken. I may be mistaken. Hold on.